Let me know.
Okay, thank you. She's Italian. She'll make a stew out of it.
I'm Italian.
You are?
100%.
Me too.
Yeah. Okay, so here's the vent.
That's why she's
so here's
with
the
a
intestine,
knife.
Right? Coming down. And then here's the gonad.
Okay.
What's a gonad?
It's an ovary or a testy. They have one ovary
well
and one
biology.
Testy. And it looks like it's a girl.
I told
we
you.
We knew it.
Why do you know it's a girl?
It looks because the girls have like, the ovary looks like a big baseball.
Oh.
You know, where the testy is long. Yeah, I'm going to pull it right up.
Oh,
you want to take a picture?
Yeah, we do.
Wow.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
See, so the gulls come up here.
And they pull
and
that
they can
out.
Pull the ovary out. They don't care about the testy.
Yeah.
Sometimes I've gone nuts. I'm like, where is it?
I get it, gone nuts.
Where can I do it?
Funny.
Okay, so I'm going to come up. And you'll see, it's funny. This body cavity is like here.
Mm-hmm.
And then all of this is meat, white meat. No red meat.
So it's not the collagen up there?
Oh,
it's
collagen
muscle?
Everywhere. Collagen's everywhere. Can't get to anything unless you get through the collagen.
So do sharks?
Wow. So that's their protection because
cool.
They don't have
They also have a very reduced skeleton.
Mm-hmm.
So I think you don't really need a defined skeleton mm-hmm. if you got that stuff.
Right.
And the bones, they're classified as the heaviest bony fish, but the bones when they dry are like balsa wood.
Wow, yeah.
The weirdest thing.
That's and still
weirdest
strong
thing.
Itself,
yeah.
Support that. Yeah. Wow.
So here's oh my god, it's huge.
Really?
Yeah.
The ovary?
It's big. So I'm just gonna try to get the tissue loose.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Looks like it doesn't look round as you described. Looks more
oval, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Do they have a mating season?
We don't know. See, here it is. Oh, it's big. Mm. And here's their bladder. I just see the urine?
Yeah.
I just ruptured the bladder.
Uh-oh, you can get
anybody
sued
want to
for
get
that.
Another
it's
picture
personal.
Before I move?
Beautiful.
We should have called
Thank
the
you.
Banner.
Okay,
it's good
so
news in the winter.
Yeah.
A little something to read about.
Yeah. Dead ocean sunfish. Look how big that is. Wow.
A lot of
it's
pee-pee.
Huge.
They're supposed to have the most eggs of any fish.
Oh, really?
Right, but all that pee.
She's not pregnant.
No, this is immature. These are immature fish.
Oh,
babies
all
inside.
All the work we've done.
Oh, that's right. It's not a mammal. I think of it as a mammal, though.
Wow.
Wow.
This is like the second eggs.
Wow.
That is
the second largest
remarkable.
One I've ever gotten.
Wow.
Very
nice. And you can see the
look
eggs
at that
just
blood
kinda,
supply.
The eggs just kind of poking out.
Oh, yeah.
It's right there.
Where? Oh.
Right in here.
Oh, I see.
That's the ovary tissue.
Wow.
Right there. So I'll take this back to Bridgewater, I'll weigh it,
yep.
Measure it, take a sample, and mm-hmm. that's what is goes to Woods Hole.
Just
really?
One?
Well, they don't really want much tissue.
No, I mean, they just have one.
Oh, they have one ovary?
One ovary.
Or one testy.
Or one testy.
Yeah.
Okay. Isn't that weird? Is that normal for fish? Mm-hmm. Normally,
fish.
Aren't
this
they symmetric?
Fish is,
right?
I know, this fish is, breaks all the rules.
Huh.
And nothing is normal for this fish. Somebody
What's
wanna
that
know?
Little sack there?
Which one? Oh,
that,
I don't know.
That's
I'm
the liver rosette. The
no,
orange.
It's teeny.
Teeny little thing
liver.
Over there.
Oh.
Huh?
Is it just something that's...
What?
I think
good
we can get
luck.
This in there.
Yeah,
really
good.
Okay, here.
You got it?
Oh,
this looks like
oh.
a cyst or something.
It's like
just
that.
Water filled.
All right, Cleveland, can I have you
so
get me a one of these containers? I gotta get some.
I would take it.
I gotta get some mucus.
Where is it, Ro? There. point to me.
I would take that. There's that a thing there.
There's a researcher in
see right here. That little
New Bedford who studies the mucus.
Oh yeah. Really?
It's a gallbladder.
Okay, I'll do it. I don't want you to get
your gallbladder.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate you.
So he studies mucus and he wants me to get mucus from the sunfish. He looks at diet.
Really?
I don't know how the heck he does that.
Huh.
This guy's got a lot of mucus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Contaminate the sample.
Really?
No, it's just
little sand.
Little sand.
Right.
What's it gonna do?
Mucus and sand.
Yeah, I'm sure that it's not the first time they had sand in a sample.
I'm gonna take skin. I always take skin. I take a plug, and I'm gonna measure it. So L, there's gonna be somewhere where you ask about the plug.
The plug.
I'm gonna measure. Look at this. Looks like a pumpkin, doesn't it?
Wow.
See the meat.
Oh, yeah.
Beautiful white meat.
Swordfish.
Don't tell anybody.
No.
Start eating these things.
No. Wow.
That's the plug.
Wow. Now I'm going to take a sample. Cool. And Cleveland, I'm going to need you again when you get a chance.
Huh? Yep, I'm here.
That is amazing.
I need
I'm looking for
one.
Plug.
If you can. I know how to get. This is white. Okay, I'm going to measure the plug in the body, and the thickness, as you see, the thickness of the reticulated collagen varies over the area of the animal. So like here and here, it's very thick. Mm-hmm. And then in other places, it's thinner. Mm-hmm. So I don't. So I just try to measure it in the same place. And L?
Yeah, I'm looking for the plug.
Okay.
Can't find it. You see it anywhere around?
About 33 millimeters. The plug. Not there.
And I'll write plug. Just down here for now. But I couldn't find it.
Oh, love it. It's perfect.
I hate the rain.
Right here. Oh, you're right there.
Where?
Right there. 30. So it's 3.3 centimeters.
Right here?
Right up here. One up. And I used to do flank and say centimeters. Yeah. I used to say yes, we're going to collect it and we're not going to do the flank.
Yes,
maybe you want to put girl.
I did do that already.
Good. Okay. So I'm going to take a sample of DNA for people. DNA.
And you're not
going
to take
loosely
a photograph.
Speaking.
Oh, I'm supposed to take a photograph.
It says photograph taken of reproductive organ. Yes or no?
Well, will you guys send me your photos?
You got like it on your camera.
Oh, great. Okay.
She's young, remember.
Oh, wait. You mean you're
young?
No. She's gonna have to. Well, she doesn't have to live with it. Actually.
No.
I think so.
No. I'm fine. Okay. Excellent. So we're going to put this in ethanol. Get back to the lab. All right.
Okay.
Now, we need a nice chunk of muscle, but I won't go for it right now. Just don't let me forget.
Eric's pretty strong.
So here's, what is that thing? Well,
I think you should take that.
It's just
part of the bladder.
It came through. See, it,
it
came
through
the body.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, you're right.
It's a hernia. Gave
hernia.
Hernia. Okay.
Wow.
Her hernia. Not a hisnia. Okay.
Wow.
Wow, look at this. See how it's like sheetrock. Now, this animal's not fresh, but if it was fresh, it would be rigid.
Really?
It's the weirdest thing I've ever seen.
Which is the weirdest thing you've ever seen?
This fish. It's the weirdest thing.
Yeah. Okay. We're having fish and chips later. You want to stick around? Yeah, they're going to be good. And we haven't even cooked it yet.
All you can eat.
Sushi.
Now, the kidney usually, or liver, usually has round worms.
Like that?
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow, a lot of roundworms.
Yeah.
Golly, man.
They're said to be the heaviest parasitized fish.
Well, because they're so slow, right?
Really?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah.
External, too.
And internal, yeah. If they're fresh, you'll see that they have parasites here, 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 here. And if you look closely, they're all different.
It asks
really?
You to photograph it.
What? Oh, Eric's got it. Yeah, Eric, you gonna send me your photos?
Yes, dear.
Okay. Now, the other thing...
Get a photo of the round one.
...that yep. I have to do before it gets too dark on me is...
Parasites, you, liver, gills,
can I jump
muscle,
in there?
GI.
Liver.
I got the liver.
Liver, yeah. Oh. Yeah. There's gonna be... They're probably everywhere.
Gills, muscle,
and I'm not good at this, is I'm gonna go for the otoliths. Most bony fish, like cod and haddock, have calcified structures in the head, in the skull, called otoliths. And the otoliths help them somehow balance in a three-dimensional water column. So I thought, ocean sunfish, heaviest bony fish, their otoliths will be like pancakes. But I was wrong. Their otoliths are so small, they're like a dried lentil. So here's the hard part, is to get in to the skull, and I'm not good at it.
That would explain why they're always swimming sideways.
Well, yeah. That might, yeah. Hmm. So I usually can get to the skull if I go behind the eye.
Okay.
And I think this is the skull right here.
We're getting just in there.
Right there.
Oh, wow.
It's right here.
I see it. Totally a bone. Look at that skull, Ro. See it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep. See?
Huh.
If I cut too close to the eye, then the eye goop comes out. And the hard part is to get into there and not pull out the otoliths. As you're doing it. Okay, so that, there is the inside of the skull.
So this should be their inner ear?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, and now I'm going to try to find...
Well, you take over because I got to go check something in the oven.
The otoliths. So...
Okay.
I'm sorry, honey.
Don't worry. When you are ready, Cleveland, I'll take another little. This time I'll take a little
okay.
container. Look at his nose.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Nostril.
Yeah. Did you collect a sample of the roundworm?
Yeah, I took a big chunk. This is the otoliths.
No.
Give me a second, he wants me to hold it. That is it.
You're kidding me.
And wow. I look for those little strands. And this is the small one. There's like three of them. So wow. There's no suctioning this and aging this. People have even
one
suctioned
more,
it.
Yeah.
Right.
People have suctioned it and there's nothing. It's all grainy.
Really?
You know, like with regular otoliths, they're hard. They're calcified. You can suction them. And I'm going to go for more if I can get it. And as you cut them, it looks like a tree. So you count the number of bands.
Wow.
I'm going to have to open it up a little more. I'm just.
And is
that
age related, the number of bands?
Well,
or
it
is
for cod and haddock, but I'm not sure about, you know, this species. I don't even know how to age them. So.
You're cutting skull?
Yeah, I'm cutting through the skull.
It's like cartilage.
Their bone is like cartilage. I can slice through their bones like cartilage. It's the weirdest thing you ever saw.
So their cartilage is very hard, but their bones are soft.
I don't know what it is. I can't, no one's been able, oh, look at that. No one's been able to tell me what this is. And I've taken it to every government lab. So there is inside his skull, and there should be a number of those otoliths, yeah. Bigger ones, just a couple bigger ones. I love you. I love you.
Ahab's a good boy.
He is a good boy. I love you. At least you're not peeing on the fish. Most dogs pee on the fish. It's like, really? How rude. Pee on my fish. My fish. I'll have to pee on it. It's mine. What a beautiful day.
Yeah.
Wasn't supposed to be this nice, was it?
Yes, it was. Every day is supposed to be nice.
Oh, I thought it was supposed to rain today.
So these aren't like the semicircular canals in the
I don't know how to fish that well.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm not a good fish person. That's why, you know, I go in and I talk to these people who are supposed to know, and they...
Right.
You all said, Eric?
No. Okay.
They're oriented in three different positions so that...
Yeah, the three planes.
Exactly. Right.
I mean, we're all based off the same structures, you know?
Okay, so you see that? Do you see the strings?
Mm-hmm.
See those strings?
No strings.
I just pulled. Here's the bigger one.
Wow.
Nice job. And then I'm just gonna see if I can get both sides. Oh, sorry. This is where I have to do this because I can't be good. And I don't know if I can get too much from a fish.
You can get both sides?
Well, I'm gonna try. I can show you their brain. You're not going to be impressed. Okay, I'm going to go for it. Now, I think I got one side. Now I want to get the other side. Just in case. So I'm going to cut here. Usually I have tide issues. Tides will be coming up on me or something like that. But this is nice. Oh, look at that.
Hmm. Wow. Wow, you should get a picture of that intact.
Question is, am I pulling anything out that I'm gonna later want?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow, that's remarkable. Any parasites in there?
Oh yeah. I don't think you'd see them as easily as the other ones.
How about heavy metals?
I don't know. You know, that would be a nice thing to check.
Yeah.
Of course I can't.
You told me they were high in mercury and lead.
Yeah. I bet you they are.
Turn off.
But they do live. They do eat pretty low on the food chain, even
they
though
do.
They're a big fish.
They do. Just those kinds of tests I can't do. You know, the kind of equipment that we might need.
I wouldn't think that there were too many heavy metals in jellyfish.
Ooh.
Nice.
Yeah. Eureka.
For you, sir.
Perfect.
That looks like cartilage.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, that's the big one. I missed. Nice. I think I got it all. See, they're in those cavities. And if I can show you the brain.
Walnut.
It is. It's right here. This is the brain right in here. Covered in that tissue.
Oh. That looks pretty primitive.
What are we looking at?
This stuff right here.
It just looks like a brain stem.
Oh,
there we go.
There you go.
There we go.
There's his brain. Not very thick. Pea brain.
Yeah.
Almond.
This almond brain. Amazing.
Wow.
Where's the
Now what?
Okay. So now that we have that, thank you, Cleveland.
Yep. Houdini.
That's good. Thank you for doing that. I'm going to find the vertebra. There is a technique that they use with some sharks. So I thought, okay, plan A, using the otoliths to age this fish isn't going to work. So now I need a plan B. My plan B is to take a section of the vertebra, and they have rings in the vertebra, and perhaps we can come up with an aging, that's the kidney, aging technique that will help us age this fish. Because we know that they're young, but we don't know how old they are. And no one has been able to age them yet. So I take a swath, a section of vertebra. Look at that meat. And I am trying to find a way to slice it thinly. In fact, we're going to try a deli slicer. We've tried everything else. A friend of mine's bringing a deli slicer to Bridgewater State. And we're going to see, because it's very soft bone, if we can age them that way. So I just got to get to the vertebra. Here's one of the supports going down to the anal fin right here. I'm just going to clean this up. But I'm looking for the first support that goes down to the anal fin tends to connect to vertebra 10. Mm-hmm. So if I can find vertebra 10, then I work backwards. And hopefully, well, they don't number them, but we do. They have 17, and I'm just trying to be consistent so that when we come up, if we ever come up with a method of aging them, we will always use the same vertebra.
Yeah.
And maybe that will help. That's insane, isn't it? Okay, so here's 10. Here's the first support that's coming in to the vertebra. And here's the vertebra. I'm gonna clean this up a little bit.
I have to get this up to the center of the fish.
So here's the vertebra here.
Okay. Not as big as I thought.
What number it is, right? Except for the fish.
See it? See, I'm going by feel. Here the support's now going to the dorsal fin.
Oh, yeah.
It's a workout.
Mm.
So I know where 10 is now, and I'm going to clean as much as I can up, cut, and
which
release it.
Which one are you
it.
Looking for?
10.
17.
Huh? 17's at that end.
Yeah, what number are you looking for?
I'm looking for 10. If I can find 10, I can cut back here.
Okay.
And then take a section forward.
Okay.
Then I always know I've got the same ones.
Okay.
So, this is the fun part, trying to get this out. I usually have to take the fin off. I got yucked. Where's that?
Mucus was in formalin, right?
Mucus what?
It was in formalin.
Mucus?
Yeah. When you took the sample, was it in formalin or in ETOH?
Oh no, I didn't. Oh, I'm gonna freeze it.
Okay.
The mucus, he
it's
wants
in a dry
it
tube.
Because I guess depending on how you, this is the kidney. It usually is red, so that tells you this guy's a little ripe. Knife sharpeners, because I'm gonna need it. What did I do with it?
Yeah, it's right there.
There you go.
So what's the brown stuff, or should I not ask?
That's the kidney. It usually is red, but this guy's been out a while.
Is it usually that liquidy?
No. He's decomposing on the inside out.
And is that a worm in there?
Probably. That's why I wouldn't eat these fish. Especially for sushi.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Okay. Oh, God. Look at how thick that is. Yeah. That reticulated collagen. So thick. Especially right here.
Really?
Yeah. Okay.
Do we know what that bulb is for? Wag, does it? No.
I wonder, you know, Cleveland, I wonder if it has anything to do with
location.
Dry hydrodynamics and.
Oh, really?
You know, moving through the water.
Yeah, possible, I guess. Yeah.
They, I'm going to cut here. I don't think it's. They have. Cut here. And then I'm going to cut along the supports. And then I'm going to cut here. And then I cut behind here.
Yeah,
and technically,
it
is.
I know, it's
completely
true.
Loose. And now the fun part comes into trying to loosen this completely. So now I have to try to get this out. To convince this thing to come out. Really? It's a fight. That's why the odorless would have been nice.
Oh, look at that. Wow.
That is very Freudian.
That is very.
That's what you see there. I don't know.
I see T10 to T5.
Yeah, there you go.
So that too is very wide.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I have to put this in KOH to remove the tissue. What we're going to do is we're going to basically disarticulate it and then measure each vertebra and then try to figure out how to age them.
God, I hope we get a basking shark someday.
Oh.
I'd love to see this. Did you do a similar process?
Yeah, well, then Greg Skomo will come down. Because they
are
protected.
You need a suit for that.
Yeah. They are protected. But you can see where each vertebra attaches right here. So this is the length of a vertebra right here. They're really big. And so we're gonna basically try to clean this up with the KOH and then
that wasn't off.
Cut them.
That's about T10 to T5.
Mm-hmm. Not bad, huh? Not too shabby. Alright, and the gulls are gonna love this.
Yeah.
But you see the rings?
So. Oh yeah.
The problem is we can't count them meaningfully. If I count them and you count them, we'll come up with different counts.
Hmm. Interesting.
See the ring?
Oh yeah.
The other sad thing is that even if we can figure out how to do this, it might not mean anything. It might not mean the age of the fish. Can you see it, Eric? You want me to tip it down? Can you see the inside?
There we go.
Huh? Can't use the ovary as a...
Well, we use the ovary to see if they're mature, and they're not mature. But we can't use... I mean, I haven't figured out a way to count those in a standardized way. Every time I look, I get a different count. Or if I count and somebody else counts, we get something different. We always try to open up the intestines to see what they ate, in case it's anything different. This is the liver. Look at the parasites here. There's some nice parasites in here.
Yeah.
All roundworms.
Sure.
The large flat white too is our
No, that's I think that's meat that's coming in. But I think these guys right here. Ooh. It's like a round, it looks like a flatworm, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Ooh. Lovely. Okay, so I'm gonna try to pull this out. Usually have to get they have a gallbladder under the liver. Look at this liver. It's cute.
Do they only eat jellyfish?
Well, that's what they say. But some people think they can also eat fish.
These are teeth, she said. Two teeth. One, two.
Two teeth. One, two.
Yeah. You have a beak like
that? Yeah, I do.
She called them teeth.
Wow. There's the gallbladder, and I could puncture it.
Oh, yeah.
Right here. Mm-hmm. And the spleen. So the gallbladder and the spleen. And again, they're a little bit ripe because of...
Roundworm on your shoe.
Dang. They have a huge...
So I notice all the parasites are long dead, too.
Yeah, well, except for the ones, if we can get into the gills, there's this really great parasite in the gill. The female and the male attached to each other, and usually they're still alive. I've taken flatworms out of the intestine and taken it back to Bridgewater, and they come back to life, and it's so gross. I tried to get them in formalin before they spread all over the table. But see, it's mainly just goo. I cut it. See, I cut it by mistake. And it's mainly just goo. Here's the stomach.
That's a nice sound, isn't it?
Yeah, sounds great, doesn't it?
Your mental. Doesn't smell worse.
Too,
I'm really surprised.
Here's the stomach. It's the top of the digestive tract.
What part are you going for?
I'm gonna pull it all out.
The
whole. Oh,
big.
Okay. Excellent.
Big bag.
No. Oh. I will.
Hefty.
Contractor.
Really big guy.
That kind with the stuff in it so it reduces the odor.
This is so cute.
Adhesions.
What was his weight again, Phil?
768.
Here's the end.
You gonna measure the length?
Yeah.
They have 30 feet, just like humans. It'll be bizarre.
I'm all shut.
Yeah.
When I do this, else I'm gonna regret it.
Yeah.
Stuck right here.
Worse.
It could. Where's the shining light in this?
What if this was July? You know what you
mean? Oh, that's true. Yeah. All right, you're right. I'm right.
Yeah. The whole fly situation alone could really make it much grosser.
This should make it in the banner.
Look at this. Wait. The gulls love this.
Wow. That's amazing.
Okay, see how the stomach is going into the esophagus?
Yep. Yep.
Right there. Yeah. So, the esophagus gets weak. So I'm going to cut it up here.
That big a stomach. I can eat you anymore.
And that was the gallbladder that I ruptured. Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to
keep your mouth closed.
Your mouth shut. All right. Now we're going to measure this thing.
Maybe.
Giant ocean sunfish.
I'm not straight, am I?
The old mayor of the town. I'm a little tired of him.
Okay.
Change him out in fall, you know.
Tell me what you got.
Ooh. Oozing at the end here. Watch out for the ooze.
What do you think? 5 meters. and 26 centimeters. 5 meters.
526?
Yeah.
Sounds good. He's got the dude for the length of the intestine.
Got it.
I'm also gonna measure. I don't know if it's on the data sheet. Do you have the length of the intestine on the data sheet?
Yeah.
I think it's there. Is there anything about the stomach?
Yep.
To the
Length of stomach.
Duct.
Yep, length of stomach. It doesn't say exactly where, and then
length of stomach. I'm going to give you one. I'm going to give you the length of the beginning of the stomach to where the bile duct. Here's the bile duct. Got it? See this tube coming right into the stomach? So I'm going to give you, and this is a new one.
So it goes into their stomach?
Well, this is where the bile, the liver stuff comes into the base of the stomach instead of the intestine. You're right, it's weird, it's different. You can always tell where the stomach starts because it's rough. Mm-hmm. See, it's really starting right here.
You can see all the...
Yeah, on the striations.
Yeah.
So that's about... centimeters, where the base of that is going.
And a lot of variability.
I know, isn't it?
A lot.
Well,
you don't have a lot of landmarks.
No.
See, so there's that stomach, that nice stomach tissue.
Oh yeah. Huh.
All that for jellyfish.
Somehow I thought that there would be
for jellyfish.
Jellyfish in there.
Right, Tan? What were they thinking?
Maybe that's what jellyfish look like when they're, taken down to their...
I can't tell you where the stomach ends.
Minimum.
See the goo? Oh. I really don't see anything that tells me where the stomach ends, other than where that...
Right, the external.
I mean, if that's the stomach, that's small.
Cut down a little bit farther and just see if there's any change in the tissue.
You can see it bends. Right here.
Right.
So it might be, I'm thinking the end of the stomach might be right here.
Yeah, right there. Hmm. It's interesting though.
It
that
looks
you don't,
muscular.
It,
right there.
Yeah, it does.
I just can't tell. I can tell two things.
Right, like this could be a kind of pylorus in there. Oh, what's that?
A cut.
That's just
it.
A cut?
I did it.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't.
Yeah, well, it looks.
Yeah,
right
it
here.
Does.
Right
it does, right in that
It does
bend.
Look like a muscular ridge in there. Do you feel it? Can you feel a muscular ridge
it
there?
It does. So you want to measure that? We'll just add a new column. And we'll do stomach length. We'll assume that's it. Where was I now?
Yeah,
right here?
It.
Right there? And that's about 33 centimeters. Right
33?
Here. Yeah. Now I can tell you one other place that I can measure. And I'm going to open this all up, and it's down here. This is the vent, and there is a sphincter.
Would you call that the upper stomach?
Yeah.
That we looked at?
Up. There to see it?
Oh yeah.
Now that.
Yeah.
That I can tell.
Oh yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
I'll clean it up a little bit.
That's the rectum then.
And I think they call it the cloaca. I think because everything ends up in it.
Yeah.
And
right.
what's
Where
the
chickens
length?
Have eggs.
Yeah.
From
So
but it's not a true cloaca because they have two openings.
I know, you're absolutely right.
It's
not
a
true cloaca.
It's not.
Because they have two openings.
You're supposed to have one, yeah.
Yeah, so this is about 31 centimeters.
Huh.
And that's, Rick, did you get that one at the... Okay, you're good? Anybody want to take a picture of the... I'll put this right here, just in case.
Mm-hmm.
Just in case. And then I'm just going to open it up and see if we find anything other than goo.
All right.
But I've never found anything but goo. This is pretty bad goo, which is an indication. Usually it's that light yellow color. Oh, indication that it's been floating around.
I don't like.
But usually, see, it's just.
DPW is gonna love this.
Oh yeah, a cleanup.
We're right in the
sun. I want.
Thanks.
Cleanup. Usually, it's usually this color. Cleanup aisle one. Now I can bury a lot of this with Elle's. Shovel.
Over there.
Yeah. But that carcass, and what we're gonna do too is, do you think they're gonna bury the carcass, Dan? You think that's what they're?
I don't know. It's a good. Looks like they just be.
Okay, here's a nice parasite. I think. See, it's right here. Yeah. Flatworms, tapeworms.
Really?
In the stomach or
how
intestine?
How do you tell the difference? They look so much the same to me.
Well, because this guy's so...
Or is it just the location?
Yeah, this guy's so decomposed, he's not making it easy. But usually they're still alive, writhing around.
Oh, kind of glad.
See, I've never...
And you'll cut into them?
I've never found anything but goo. In these intestines. No fish, no otoliths, no anything.
No beaks.
No beaks.
Nothing. No fish.
Bone.
No bone. Now, of course, I'm getting the ones that are floating around for a while, so.
Yeah.
Nothing.
Made a hell of a surge in Krillieta. Made a hell of a surge.
Slash and burn, baby. Delicate we are not. Slash and burn.
See here, you really can see the difference between the tissue up here and the tissue below.
Yeah.
That line.
Is there anything else you want to see?
Going in for those gill parasites.
All right. Could someone put the stuff in the cooler? Because they really should be on ice. And they should be. So I've got these three and all that stuff. The cooler's got ice in it. Oh, yeah, that'd be great. And I'll go for the gills.
Put the parasite in the intestine. Yeah.
At least put those on ice.
Did we collect the worms? And
oh yeah, I got some big bags.
Did we collect those GI tract worms?
No.
Perculum.
Are you going to take any of the eye, or is it just too badly damaged?
I actually would love the other.
The other eye?
Because some people can age using the eyes.
Double glove.
Are those gills there, the rake?
Those are just the, I don't know, Eric, you're going to have to tell me. Hey, listen, let me just get this. They have 4.5 sets of gills. So there's one set. Another set. Mm-hmm. See, of course, this guy is coming in the surf a lot. Oh, God, this is the hardest part. I already got you. You don't want to come off. Oh, I see.
So that debris was forced in there by the surf, or yeah. Was that actually inhaled?
No, I think it was the surf. Is like the sea turtles. They come in with a lot of...
Oh, all right. Wowie.
A lot of stuff. Okay. There you go. And they go all the way back here.
Any parasites in there?
No. Let's keep going.
It's hard to tell.
This is where it's hard to cut because it's the thickest.
Well, I have an electric carving knife in case you need to borrow it.
See how they go all the way down? All the way back.
Yeah. Sure, we could rig that up some Captain Jacks.
Pretty cool, huh? So if they had the parasites, you'd see them mm-hmm. in between here.
Mm-hmm.
And they're greenish. Look at that. Isn't that neat?
Yeah, it see really that? Is. It's amazing.
That's so the water's flowing this way and out.
Interesting okay. structures there on the...
Yeah.
Those,
Yeah, isn't that neat? And they have pharyngeal teeth. I'll try to find them for you. They have spines in their throat that they use to, we think, to keep the jellyfish down. Like turtles have spines.
I would have trouble keeping jellyfish.
No, I don't see. Yeah, that's the first one I've never found those parasites. And it might just be because it's too old. 1, 2, 3, 4 and a half.
They abandon the ship when they know their host is dead, or?
Not usually. They have a tongue.
Yeah, right.
Right.
Okay. Okay, so the spines are back here. Can anybody see him? I don't know if I'm... Oh! This step isn't helping.
Yeah, well, is that rough?
No, no, like you'll see. Oh, yeah. They're nasty. When I stick my hand in there, usually I cut it. So let's take some gills off. Mm-hmm. All right.
Gill retractor.
This is good stuff.
Ah, it's ocean sunfish. Wow. Yeah.
There they are. Look at these things.
What?
Oh, wow.
See these things? Yeah. I'll clean them up in a second. Oh, my God.
Amazing.
They're spines.
And you amazing. Think they're used to help keep the jellyfish from coming back?
And
up
some people think shredding too.
Wow. Yeah.
Like that. I'll clean it up.
Oh, right there. Got it.
Neat stuff. And they're muscular. And they've got a lot of connective, you know, like they're like they can really control them. See the bulb?
Yeah.
Oh, I want a gill. Neat, huh? Look at that.
Yeah.
Yes, he's very young and very timid.
Woo! Cute! Don't roll in it. You'll never get it out.
Yeah.
No, don't worry. No.
You're all set?
You collected the vertebra section, right?
Yeah, I hope so. I gotta get that on ice.
And how about this, the tissue of the anterior pectoral fin and the flank area? Did you save that?
No, I'm not gonna do the flank. Okay. But we quit doing that because we're running out of storage in the freezers.
Okay. How about anterior of the pectoral fin?
Yeah, we got that one. There we go.
Any idea how it deceased or however it was?
Looks like a suicide.
Suicide mission.
Suicide by beach.
It went off its jellyfish diet.
That's right.
Yeah, right. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah. And there's a second one right here. The upper throat.
You could say dehydration.
Huh? See the second one?
Dehydration.
Second.
See the second pair?